It's been more than 50 years since NASA's Apollo program ended. Between 1968 and 1972, 24 astronauts were sent to the moon. Back then, the crews were all men and all white. But next year, NASA's Artemis II mission around the moon will look different. It's comprised of four astronauts, including a black man, a Canadian, and a woman. That woman is Christina Koch. She holds the record as the woman who spent the longest time in space. Recently, I visited her at the Johnson Space Center just outside of Houston to talk about her upcoming mission and inspiring the next generation. Tell me about the Artemis II mission.
Artemis II is the first in a big campaign of Artemis missions to go back to the moon, and this time to go sustainably, responsibly, and to stay, to learn everything that the moon has to teach us, to bring those benefits back to Earth, and to really just answer humanity's call to explore deeper.
Can you give us more details about the mission? How long is it going to take? What exactly happens?
Absolutely. Since this is the first time crew has ever been on board the Orion space capsule, we're going to spend a day or so in what's called a high Earth orbit. We're going to stay close to home while we test out our life support systems. And then if all looks good, about a day after our mission start, a day after launch, we're going to do that big, what we call a translunar injection burn, and head to the moon. That'll be about 3 days on the way to the moon. We're going to go around it and see the actual far side with human eyes for the first time in a long time, potentially see places that have never been seen with human eyes a few days back, and then splashing down.
What is the goal in this particular mission?
Our goal as a crew is to enable the next missions that are coming in the Artemis campaign. That means the people we know are going to be walking on the surface of the moon, exploring the moon, doing the amazing science there. And our goal is just to basically do as much as we can so that that next mission can happen flawlessly. This is the first time people have ever been on board this rocket, this capsule, that we've ever had to come out of the ocean in it. And so our goal is just to basically test all the new systems and give as much feedback as we can to the team so that we can make it as good as it can be going forward.
I got to walk through the capsule
Yes.
as a little test before we get a little chance to get a tour inside with you. It's not big. There's four of you.
That's correct. Well, I like to tell myself that in space, when you have microgravity and you can be, you know, utilize the whole 3D volume of it, it feels a little bit bigger. That's mostly true, but it is a little bit of a road trip with your friends in a tiny RV that you don't get to leave. Yes.
This particular mission is not that long, but when I had heard that you were in space the longest, mm-hmm. I always thought, like, is there a point where you just get sick of people? Just, you know, because in this capsule, you're literally elbow to elbow.
We will literally be elbow to elbow. We'll probably be foot to nose. We'll be a lot of things in, you know, microgravity when we're floating around.
You need to like the people a lot.
You sure do. And we work on that. It's really neat. NASA is very focused on mental health, on the fact that performance is based off of having a team that you gel with and that you've come up with these rules of behavior. We call it expeditionary behavior skills. And we work on those skills just like we work on our piloting skills. And it's a really great organization in that sense to be a part of.
Oh, that's amazing. I didn't realize that. Mm-hmm. You're also a diverse team, probably the most diverse team going
up
for this particular mission. What does that mean? I mean, is it important? Is it, does it not matter? Is 2024,
right.
Who cares?
Well, you know, what I think is so important about it is that decades ago, we made the decision as an agency, as a country, as every company even has made this decision that we are better when we go for all and by all. We're better when we accept anyone who has a dream, who's willing to work hard for that dream, to have their contributions on the table. And we've done that as an astronaut corps so long ago that our corps is representative of America just naturally. That, to me, is what's really worth celebrating.
While I was at the Space Center, Christina gave me a tour of the mock-up Orion spacecraft that they train in. We're going to show you that a little bit later in the show.